Hi there. Welcome to another Blender tutorial. Well, I'll be showing you how to create procedural materials with Blender's shader nodes and use them to generate an abstract landscape like the one you see here. To get things going, fire up Blender and add a plane. Then, go to the Plane's Modifiers tab, add a subdivision surface modifier and set it to simple. Although the max number of subdivisions is 6, you can go further than that by stacking multiple subdivisions on top of each other. These subdivisions will give us the geometric detail we need for procedural displacement mapping. Now, head over to the shading viewport, add a new material to the plane object, and make sure you select the displacement option in the settings. If you don't see this option, it's because you haven't selected cycles for your render engine. You can do that in the render properties. Go ahead and delete the principled BSDF shader that was added by default to the new material and replace it with a diffuse shader node. Then, add a texture coordinate node, a noise texture node, a color ramp node, a math node, and finally, a vector math node. The noise texture node generates the base values for our displacement map. The color ramp node allows us to limit the minimum and maximum values generated by the noise texture. The math node, when set to snap, will make the displacement map increase in fixed steps, giving it an abstract look. The vector math node, when set to multiply, will take the height value and create a vector along the z-axis for the displacement map. Finally, to give the model some color variation, add a color ramp node. Now, to clean up the side faces of the displacement map, add a geometry node, a vector math node, a map range node, an emission shader node, and a mix shader node. Here, be sure to set the vector math node to dot product. This subset of nodes will add an emission color to any and all faces of the model that make a right angle with the z-axis. Go ahead and tweak the colors and parameters of any of the nodes to get the look and feel you like for the model. Blender's shader graph enables 3D artists to procedurally generate highly detailed landscapes. Now, to add more detail to the displacement map, add a mapping node, a gradient texture node, a color ramp node, and a math node. Set the gradient texture node to spherical and the math node to multiply. This subset of nodes enables you to limit the 3D model to a circular area. Using a similar approach, you can add any number of textures and combine them to generate very detailed displacement maps. This tutorial was inspired by a video from Ducky3D. This is my take on the subject, with a bit more math and a more structured approach. That being said, Ducky3D has, in my opinion, some of the best tutorials on procedural materials. I'll leave a link to his channel in the description. So that's it for today. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care.